All right. So I guess most of us are here. So we'll start with our session. So this session is guided towards guiding you through CA Foundation, through the various things which are there in CA Foundation. So we've jotted down a few FAQs, which are as follows. So what are the FAQs? What are the frequently asked questions relating to CA Foundation and the course? That what is the last date of registration? What would be the fee structure or what would be the fee payment that you would do to ICI? What is the procedure for registration at ICI? And then we talked about examination and passing criteria in our individual subjects, but we'll also give you an overview of all the subjects put together and we'll show you some basics. And then we'll also guide you through the registration at Top Yoga and what is the way forward and how would we take these classes forward at Top Yoga. And we'll take a virtual tour to the ICI website and the BOS Knowledge Portal. What is BOS? BOS is Board of Studies. So we'll take a tour through that website because that website will help you a lot during your preparation. All right. So taking one question at a time, what was the first question that we have last day?
Yeah, Darpan sir. So yeah. Students, basically what we are doing is we are dividing this session into three parts. Okay. One is with respect to ICAI, that is ICAI registration. Okay. Secondly, we have Top Yoga. Okay. The queries with respect to Top Yoga, the registration and other things at Top Yoga. And the third one is with respect to the website of ICAI, the Board of Studies Knowledge Portal. So that is how we have got three parts in this session. And of course, after these three parts gets over, any other questions which you have, you can ask us. Okay. And we'll be giving you a chance to speak as well, not just type. Okay, whenever the time comes, whenever Darpan sir and I feel that, yes, we have to give you time to speak, that time you'd be speaking as well, apart from, messaging or texting. Till then, I would request you to switch off your video as well as mute yourself so that we are not disturbed in the session. Okay?
Right.
So thank you so much. Now, Darpan sir.
Relating to as to when can you speak, we'll divide that also. So after we complete the ICAI portion, the starting four questions, we'll give you a chance to speak. Then you can ask the questions which are relating to the ICAI thing, to the registration, fee structure and the procedure. Then we'll tell you about Top Yoga and its way forward. And then we'll also open the tab. And then lastly, when we do virtual tour, after that also we can open up for discussion. All right. So you can write down your doubts. You can write down whatever is coming into in your mind. And then we can discuss at one point of time by unmuting you. We'll unmute you. All right. So what is the first thing? The first doubt that the student gets is what is the last date till when I can register myself for CA Foundation, right? So the last date for registering yourself with ICAI. ICAI, as we told you, is what? Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. It is the apex body which is governing your studies and also the chartered accountants. So that is like a university, like Usmania University governs all the degrees in Hyderabad. That is a apex university or an apex body for chartered accountancy. So you would register yourself with ICAI, and for that registration, the last date is 30th June. All right. Normally what happens by 30th June 2020, your 12th examination results come out, right? You give your examinations, your result also come out, and then you upload your mark sheet and get registered with ICAI. But right now, since COVID scenario is there, what is happening? There are certain examinations like CBSE and ICSE where the examinations are still not over. Leave about the results thing. The examinations are only not completed completely. So that is why ICAI for this year has started provisional registration as a scheme. Now, what is this provisional registration? Provisional registration is giving you a chance to register yourself without your 12th mark sheet. All right. Previously, what used to happen? You could register with ICAI only if you had 12th mark sheets in your hand. All right. You will have to upload that 12th mark sheet in order to get registered. But now, since they also know that 12th exams are only not over in many places, and the results, we don't know as to when would they be declared. So they're giving you an opportunity, or they're giving you a chance to get yourself registered provisionally right now, where you can have a provisional registration with ICAI by uploading your admit card of 12th. All right. So you need not upload your 12th mark sheet, but you will have to upload your 12th admit card in order to get provisionally registered. Then afterwards, when you get your results or when your exams get over of 12th, that also you'll have to upload whenever you get your result. All right. So what is the last date till by when should you go to the portal and get yourself registered? On or before 30th June. But is someone stopping you from getting registered today? No, nobody is stopping you. You can get yourself registered today also, but that will be a provisional registration, right?
Okay. So now all the right. question comes that is this registration mandatory? Is it compulsory that you have to go to ICAI or you have to get yourself registered with ICAI? And the answer is yes. If you want to do CA, as Darpan sir just now mentioned, that this particular course is regulated or this particular profession is regulated by the body ICAI, Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. So it's mandatory that every student who wants to pursue this course have to get themselves registered with them. Okay. And earlier we used to go to the office physically and get ourselves registered, but that's not required now. You need to just visit the portal. Now Darpan sir will be guiding you on that. Don't worry. So you need to go to the website, go to the portal and do the necessary things by way of which you can get registered. And for that, as he said, the last date is 30th June 2020. In case you want to write the examination in November 20, that also you please understand. If you're writing examination in November 2020, then the last date is 30th June 2020. So if you say, sir, I missed this out. Let's say I get registered on 5th of July 2020. Then please understand, 5th of July 2020 would enable you to write examination in May 2021. That means 5 days delay can cause 6 months of delay in your examination. So you'll be missing out 6 months. You'll have to wait for your examination for another 6 months. So don't forget this date, 30th June. Okay. Acha. You'll say, sir, why do we need to get registered with Topyuk Educations when we are already registering with ICAI? See, to do CA course, you have to get registered with ICAI. But in order to learn the subjects, in order to know the subjects and study, the coaching part which is there is what Topyuk Educations provide. Okay, like Usmania University, as sir was giving an example, is like a board or university, and the different colleges are there, no, which gives you the coaching or did they teach you. Same way here, you may say Topyuk Education is an academy, is like a college which will impart the subject, and then ICI is like your university which is going to regulate it. But we don't have different universities. Like Usmania University is there in Hyderabad, but there are different universities in different parts of India. But as far as this is concerned, there is only one body throughout India. Throughout India, we have got only ICAI. Okay. No other body which governs this particular course. But when it comes to academies, classes, there are multiple classes. Topyuk Educations is one among them. Okay. Yes. Yes, Darpan sir. You may go ahead.
All right. Great. So what is your next FAQ or what is the next frequently
Nayan,
asked
one
question?
Sorry, Darpan. Nayan, yeah. We'll be helping you better. Don't worry. If you have this problem, you can always shoot later. Okay.
Right. So Nayan is asking that the website is not opening, but we'll help you with that also. All right. So what is the ICAI fee structure? The ICAI fee structure, that means the fee that you need to pay to get registered with ICAI is 9,200. All right. The amounts which are given below, which is for subscription for students' journal, subscription for members' journal, that's an optional amount. If you pay that amount, then that journal comes to your home on a monthly basis, right? That journal consists of information relating to finance, relating to taxes, relating to accountancy, relating to the things that ICAI is doing, right? So that journal is an optional amount that you want to, if you want to pay, you can subscribe to them. But 9,200 is a minimum amount that you will have to pay in order to get registered with ICAI for CA foundation course. All right.
So now you might ask, sir, what would you suggest? What would you, say, shall we pay 9,200 or 9,800? Right. Definitely, we will say go for 9,800 because the journal which is being, sent by ICAI to the student, okay, is very useful. Same way the members journal, which is being sent, which will be sent to student as well, will be quite useful because you can find the latest updates, articles on certain topics or matters. So in a way, you'll be always updated with things around by way of that journal. And that journal normally, let me tell you, is not for 400 or 200 rupees. The cost is huge, but this is the benefit which ICA is providing to the student, that at the time of registration itself, if you pay this, then you have to pay just 600 for journal.
Right, that's for an yearly subscription of 600 rupees. All right, so Arjun is asking to repeat fourth and fifth point. Arjun, fourth and fifth point is relating to a journal. Here, the journal is like a magazine, like how you get magazines of news or magazines of entertainment, like that magazine of a magazine which is prescribed by ICI. Now, what does this consist of? This consists of what is ICI starting, the new laws or new rules, things relating to our articles written relating to taxation, costing, accountancy. So whatever is relevant to your subject, whatever is relevant to a chartered accountant, those things would be included in such journal.
If you want to become a successful chartered accountant, if you want to deserve to be a chartered accountant, remember guys, you need to be updated. So if ICI is publishing certain changes or amendments and all, and is sending you that, don't you think it's a very good chance to get updated sitting at home? Right. So like you read Filmfare magazine or some other magazines. Now it's the time that you should start reading even the journal relating to CA field and the subjects which are relating to our profession. So that's the use of journal.
Right. All right. Yes. So 9,200 is the minimum amount, and then 600 is for the journal. So your total would be 9,800 that you pay to ICI. Right. All right. So what is the procedure for registration? So as we already told you that you need to get registered online. The facility of getting registered manually by going physically to the ICI's office in Hyderabad or in any other city has now been closed, right? You will have to only get registered online by filling out their form online. And where do you get such form? So we'll show you when we go to the website also. But right now, to just tell you, on the ICI's website, there's a tab called Students. If you click on that tab, course registration forms will open, and in that form you will find foundation form. So if you click on that foundation form, you need to make an ID. Like you make a profile on Facebook or profile on Instagram, like that you'll have to make an ID on ICI's website also as a student. So in order to make that ID, you'll have to fill your basic details such as your phone number and email ID. So give your correct phone number or the phone number that you will be using, because there'll be a lot of information which will be coming on that, like updates as to the last date of registration, what do you need to do, what not you need to do. Those updates will come. Along with that, you will also get an OTP, that one-time password you will require in order to log in when you first time log in through that website. All right. So give your correct phone number and your email ID when you're actually filling out those basic details in the first. All right. So just to give you a gist as to what is the information that they ask, this is the information. Just your first name, middle name, last name, what's your date of birth, email address and mobile numbers. These two tabs are very important, with obviously the other information also, because other information, you cannot fill them wrong. Right. All right. So what do you do after this? After this, you get your ID created. Your ID is created where you can type your username and password, and you can actually log into the portal. After you log into the portal, that is when the actual form is displayed, the actual form that you need to fill. I'll show you that form also as to what is that form. So you filled this, you got an OTP on your mobile, you successfully verified that OTP with them. So then you can log in using your username and password, right? After you log in with username and password, this is the tab that you can see. There are, if you can see on the above, there are three tabs. One is personal details. The second is qualifications details. Third is payment details. In the first tab, personal details, as the name suggests, what will this be? This will be your address, your name, your date of birth, your nationality as to, and what is your email address and phone number and everything relating to your personal details, right? What will be the second tab? The second tab is relating to your qualifications. Here is the page where you need to upload your 10th and 12th marks. So obviously you'll have your 10th mark sheet ready, where you can click a picture of that using Cam Scanner, because Cam Scanner is an app which will take better pictures in a scanned manner and it'll convert that automatically into PDF. So that's a better way of taking pictures. So download Cam Scanner and just take a picture of your 10th mark sheet. and then
fill out. Yeah, Tapan, 1 minute. Please keep a notebook and pen in front of you so that if something, important, which we are talking about, you can make a note of it. Like now, just now, Darpan sir said, if you're taking any picture to upload it on the website, better to use the app Cam Scanner. If you've already downloaded it, if you're already using it, that's well and good. But in case you're not, then please write down the name Cam Scanner. Okay. Download it, and by way of Cam Scanner, please take the pic, and as he said, automatically it gets into the PDF format and then upload it.
Right. So you need to fill out your 10th details as to what year did you pass, what was your percentage, and upload your mark sheet for 10th. Coming to 12th, what would you do? Right now, there might be students who have written all the exams, but they're waiting for results. Or there can be students who have not written entire exams, right? There are students whose one paper or whose two papers are still left to be written. So in both the cases, when your results are awaited or when you have not written all the exams, you can upload your admit card. You might be having your admit card or your hall ticket, right? So that your hall ticket, you can upload. You have a provision of uploading your hall ticket. When you upload your hall ticket, it will automatically tell you that this is a provisional registration and not a complete registration, right? I've told you in the starting that they've started this concept of provisional registration because they know that everybody will not have mark sheet in their hands at the time of registration, right? All right. So what was the first tab? First tab was for personal details. The second tab was for qualifications details. And now the third tab is for payment details. What do you do here? Here, first you upload certain documents. What are these documents? The first two documents are compulsory for you and the rest three are optional. The first is a photo of yours and a signature. Again, how will you upload your signature? Sign on a white piece of paper, on a blank piece of paper. And again, take an image with that app called Cam Scanner and then upload that file here. All right. So a photo, a passport size photo and a signature would be required.
And guys, please remember the photo has to be the latest passport size photograph. Don't take out your fifth class photograph and upload it. Huh? I know during lockdown period, you might be recollecting your memories and maybe could find some childhood photographs, but please don't upload them. Yes, right, Darpan sir.
Right.
And secondly, when you are taking the picture of your signature, please use a plain paper. Okay, don't use a single ruled paper or some other paper. Please use a plain paper and signature and then take the picture and upload it.
Right. Now, you must be wondering as to what is the importance of this picture and the signature. So, this picture and the signature would get printed in your admit card for CA Foundation. The admit card that you receive for CA Foundation, your picture and that signature that you're signing here would get printed at in that admit card. And when you actually write your exam, that is when also you need to sign. You need to put your signature on the answer sheet, right? So it will help them to verify as to whether the person who has registered, whether that person is only writing the exam or not, right? So obviously you will need to upload a recent picture and not very old. All right. So this is as to what documents do you upload. After that, if you see down, there's payment details. What are the details there? That details is the details that we saw in the second slide of ICI fee structure, where 9,200 was the minimum amount that you need to pay in order to get registered. And then 600 was optional for journal, right? So you need to pay this amount after you upload everything and after you fill out all those details. You need to pay via online mechanism and then you can get yourself registered. All right. Correct. So we've written here also that on successful payment, system will automatically generate the form which shall be printed. Ambika, your college leaving certificate is not compulsory. So if you see the asterisk marks there, the asterisk marks are on upload the photo and upload the signature. If you don't have your college leaving certificate, you might be having your school leaving certificate. You can upload the school TC. If you don't even have school TC, because you might have given that to your college authorities, you can also leave that point because that is not compulsory to upload right now.
Only the asterisk ones are compulsory, Ambika.
Right. Like copy of visa. Like you might not be having a copy of visa, so you will not upload that. So Sumedh will help you with that. I guess it's not opening today because yesterday I opened and I've taken these screenshots yesterday only. So the website was opening yesterday and the form was also opening. These screenshots are of yesterday only.
Sometimes there is a problem, Sumedh, with the website, but don't worry, it's not always. Huh? So you may try. If you have tried today, maybe we can try in the evening or maybe later, maybe next tomorrow as well. It's not right. That it doesn't open at all.
All right. So what do you need to keep ready? You need to keep ready a copy of class 12th and your 10th mark sheet. If you don't have that, 12th admit card and one recent color photo passport size photograph. Also, earlier what used to happen? Yeah. And signature. Right. Earlier, what used to happen earlier when you manually went and physically registered with ICI? They used to give you books and those books were not couriered at your home directly. But now what is happening, since everything is online, you would receive the books also through courier. So they will give you a tracking number of when they actually send out the books. You can track your courier as to where is the shipment with that tracking number. And you get your books also through courier directly delivered at your door, at your home. Okay.
Right. So you will get, first of all, the acknowledgement for the registration you do. Secondly, right. You will get the books through courier for which the tracking mechanism is in place. Okay. So the books which you will receive from ICAI will be the study materials, which are even there in PDF format on their website, which we will show you once we go to the website of ICAI.
Right. ICAI books.
I hope you have understood which books, study material provided by ICAI. Those books, you will get it. The physical copy, you will get it through courier. Dimple, right. I hope it is okay. Thank you.
No, we need not pay extra for that study material. And please message to everyone rather than messaging me privately.
Yeah, Samkit, there are e-books. PDF format, e-book is available.
Yeah, we'll also show you as to where are those ebooks available when we take a tour, when we take a virtual tour of ICAI website. All right. So we discussed subject-wise in our own respective classes as to what is the passing criteria and how do you take examinations? Is it theory-based? Is it MCQ-based? Once again, to just tell you as to what is the base, your paper 1 and paper 2. What is paper 1? Accounts. And paper 2 is law and BCK, right? These are theory-based papers and these will be of 3 hours each. So this examination will be, the duration of the examination would be 3 hours. Your paper 3 and paper 4.
Paper 2, 1 minute. Paper 2 is business laws and BCR.
BCR, yeah. I told BCR.
By mistake, you said BCR. Apology. So let me just correct. No problem. So paper 1 is accounts and paper 2, as you know, business laws and BCR. So these two are objective and are of 3 hours. See, first, we have told you about registration. Now you're done with your registration. You got the acknowledgement. You got the books now. Now, after that, you'll start studying. That studying will be done with Topyug Educations in case you're joining Topyug Educations. And then in the study process, probably you'll be writing certain tests and other things. Once that is over, once the study period is over, then you'll be writing examination with ICAI. Examination conducted by ICAI. So we are showing you now the examination and passing criteria of not Topyug, again of ICAI. Okay. Yes, Darpan sir.
Right. Also, what is the minimum marks, or everybody asks this question as to what are the passing marks? What marks do I get in order to pass CA Foundation? So there are two criteria and you'll have to satisfy both the conditions together, both the criteria together. What is the first criteria? The first criteria is saying that you will have to score a minimum of 40% in each paper. All right, not in each subject, because subjects are different. Paper 2 has two subjects. So what are they saying? They're saying in each paper, right? So in paper 1, paper 2, paper 3, paper 4, individually, you will have to score a minimum of 40%. What is that? That is 40% of 100, which is 40 marks, right? So you need to score a minimum of 40 marks in each subject. Let's say I scored 40 in each subject. What would be my total? My total will be 160, right? 40 into 4, which is 160. But does this 160 make me to pass CA Foundation? No. Why? Because there's a second criteria also, which is saying your grand total, the total of all the papers or the aggregate of all the papers should be at least 50%. All right. What is the aggregate of all the papers? 400, right? 100 of each paper. So 400 is the aggregate. What is 50% of that? 200 is the 50% of that. So 200 on your total is the minimum that you'll have to score in order to pass CA Foundation, along with 40% in each subject. We'll also show you an illustration in the next slide so that you can understand it better as to how does these 40% and 50%, this mechanism, how does it work? All right. As we told you, paper number 1 and 2 will be subjective and 3 and 4 will be objective. An objective type of questions, plus 1 is for every right answer, and there's minus 0.25 for every wrong attempted answer. If you don't attempt that question, then there's no plus, no minus, right? All right. What can be the examples then? What can be the illustrations of how much can you score and what will be your result? So if a student scores 40 in each paper, as we took an example, and the total would be 160, then the result would not be passed because he has not achieved that 50% marks in aggregate, right? It should be minimum of 200 in total, and that is why that is in red. Again, when you see the case B, the student has scored 60 and 40, and then 50 and 45, which is again all greater than 40. But in the total, he has just missed the marks by 5, right? He had to get 200 as a minimum total score, but he scored 195, and that is why he could not pass. Let's see case C. In case C, he scored 70, 60, and 60 in accounts, maths, and economics. Right? But where is the problem? The problem lies in law paper where he has scored just 35. Right? This is falling short of 40% in each subject. 40 is the minimum that you should get in each subject. That in case C, we have taken the example of 35 as score in law, and that is why that person could not pass the examination. His total was beyond 50% of aggregate, but still he could not clear because of one paper where he scored less than 40%, right? And then D is 50, 50, 15 each. That means he has passed 40% criteria in each paper. And then 200, exact 200 will also pass you, right? Since it is exact 200, that means it's exact 50% of your total. That is also enough in order to pass CA Foundation. Then the E case is 60, 70, 55, 45, which is all more than 40%. And total is 230, which is again more than 50% of total. And that's why in E question also, there's pass. All right, Gautam sir, do you want to say anything?
One thing here. Yeah. I think someone was talking about how many questions are there. Beta, if you have attended my first session, I've already talked about it. For business laws, there are 6 questions, out of which 5 has to be answered. Same way, if you want to know about the number of questions in each paper, the respective subject, the person who's taking up or who's handling the respective subject can help you there. So maybe, I think already Pranav sir also has told in his session and Darpan sir also told. Yeah,
we covered that in first session.
Yes, that has been covered. So in case you have missed out, you can ask the respective person. Okay.
Right.
I am not okay, there, so you have to attend. You cannot say I'm not there. We've already uploaded all the videos also on our TopYouth channel, all the 5 classes of each subject. So you can be there. Okay. Yeah, we are not here to discuss the, subject wise, this detailed discussion here. And anyways, we are covering that in our subject, respective subject, because that person can handle it better. Okay, Sahil.
Right.
Yeah, other questions, maybe Darpan sir, you can
take. So, Sahil, you can go back to our first session, which is uploaded on YouTube, and you can go see that. Also, there's another question which Harsha is asking as to in case A, why is the result fail? So, the result is failure because the total has not reached 200. What did I tell you? What are the two conditions in the second point? Minimum of 40% in each paper, and it's not or. It's and, that means both the conditions have to be satisfied, and minimum of 15 aggregate. So did he score minimum of 15 aggregate? What is 50% of 400? It's 200. It is way short of 200, which is 160. And that's why that is in red. And that is the reason why in case A, that the result is failed. All right.
And in case you look at C, you will find the total is 225, which is obviously beyond 200. But then because in paper number 2, that is law and BCR, you find the marks is 35, which is below 40. So that's why that is failed. So it is important to understand that each paper you should get 40 and above, and overall, that is the total should be equal to or more than 200. Both conditions fulfilled, then only you are passed. Otherwise not. Okay.
Right. All right. So moving forward, so we have finished as to what
Priyal,
is.
Priyal, 1 minute. Priyal is asking some question. If one question is attempted but is wrong, plus 0.25 are reduced or only. See, Priyal, as Pranav sir has taken an example also the, in the first class, that if you are answering, let's say, 50 questions, okay, and you're answering 50 questions, and let's say 40 questions are the correct answers, okay, you've answered them correctly. So 40 into 1, each correct answer has got 1 mark, so 40. And then let's say the rest of the 10 questions which you have answered are wrong. So 10 into 0.25, okay, that is negative 0.25. So it will become minus 2.5. So 40 minus 2.5 is 37.5. And then you'll say, sir, rest of the 50 questions I have not attempted only. So you have not attempted means 0. So 37.5 plus 0 makes the total as 37.5. This is how it goes. So every correct answer, 1 mark. Every wrong answer, negative 0.25 for each question. And then unattempted question means it is 0. No plus, no minus.
Right. So Priyal, it's negative 0.25 and not negative 1.25.
Yeah.
And Ambika asks as to why is in case E, why is it pass? In case E, since every subject he has scored more than 40%, and in total also it's more than 50. So in every subject he has scored 40, and total also is more than 200. That is why it's a pass situation. All right. So we can open up for your doubts now. I'll try to unmute you guys. Okay, so I've tried unmuting, but there's a lot of disturbance that we can hear from the background noises or the noises that are around you. So if you can sit in an undisturbed environment, or if it's not possible for you to sit in an undisturbed environment, then you don't unmute yourself. So I will allow you guys to unmute yourselves. So if you can press on that screen, if you press on that screen, you'll get an option on the left side where you can unmute yourself. So if you want to ask a doubt, just please unmute yourself, and then you can speak. So 1 second, I'll just, yeah, I've allowed you guys to unmute yourselves by yourself. So Gautam sir also has been muted. Gautam sir, can you try unmuting yourself if you can do? Yes.
Yes. Yeah. Now I'm unmuted. Yeah. I was saying that let us first ask, is there any doubt of yours which you think you would like to share with us by your voice instead of messaging? If yes, then you can unmute yourself. And
or you can
speak.
Or you can just type on the chat box and we can unmute you.
That can be done. That's better, I guess, because
that's better.
Unmute everyone, then there's a lot of doubt. I mean, a lot of noise around, and correct, it's disturbing for everyone.
So if you want to ask about, you can just, yes, sir, I have a doubt. If you just put that, we'll unmute you. If there's no doubt, then we can move forward.
Yeah, there's no doubt. So we can move forward, I guess.
All right. So what is the procedure for registering at TopYog? As most
so
of
now,
you
one
know,
minute, sir.
Right.
So first thing we have covered, first part of our session we have covered, that is about ICAI registration fee, okay, and passing criteria and all. Now we are moving into the second part of our session, which is relating to TopYog. As I've told you, it is mandatory for you to get registered with ICAI. Then only you can do your CA course. Then only you can write your CA examination. Now we are talking about TopYog because that's going to provide you the coaching, right? So with respect to TopYog, we are talking about certain things.
Right. All right. So what is the fees at TopYog? As most of you know, as I've been talking to everybody regarding this, what is the total fees? The total fees is 15,000 if you pay that in one installment. But if you want to pay in two installments, then we are giving you a chance to pay 10,000 in first installment. And then within a month, you'll have to pay 8,000. So the total will be 18,000 in the second scenario. So you can choose to pay either in one installment or you can choose to pay in two installments. Now, how do you pay this since there's lockdown?
Now, 1 minute, sir. Yeah. And please note that normally the fee which we collect for our face-to-face classes is rupees 30,000. But then because of lockdown and because we're not able to conduct face-to-face classes completely, we have already given a discount of 50%. When we are asking you to pay 15,000, 50% discount is already offered there. And in case you're not able to pay 15,000 in one installment, that is where we have given you installment facility. But yes, there the discount would be slightly lesser. Okay. And it would come out, the net fee will be coming out to 18,000. Yeah. Right. Now payment. Yeah.
Now, how would be the payment mechanism? Since there's lockdown, you cannot come to the office or we cannot collect the amount in cash. That is why you'll have to pay through an online mechanism. What are the options available? One is that you can do a bank transfer where you can directly...
For which details are given already here.
Right. You can see these details. These details will also put it on our group where you can see the details for your easy access. So these details you can use to online transfer your funds, or you can actually go to a bank and deposit an amount in this bank account if you have not activated online banking, right? Because there are queries as to the opposite person or the student asks as to my father or my parents, they don't have online banking facility. In that case also, you can actually visit a bank and you can deposit the amount because deposit facilities are available right now. So you can deposit the amount in this bank account in order to get yourself registered. Or you can Google Pay or Phone Pay. That facility is also available. If you're using Google Pay or if you're using Phone Pay, then on this phone number which is given, you can Google Pay or Phone Pay us. This phone number also will put it on our group. Also, after you pay, let's say you've done an online transaction where you've transferred online, then you can send us the screenshot of the screenshot of your mobile where you've where it is shown clearly that you've transferred the funds to us. Or you also receive an acknowledgement. You can either send the acknowledgement or the screenshot that you have. If you're going to the bank and paying, then you can give us the deposit slip, that deposit slip with the bank stamp that the amount is deposited with the bank account detail, which is given here, right? So we need that proof or we need that acknowledgement or screenshot.
If you don't share that the acknowledgement or maybe the screenshot of the payment which you have done, then how would we know that you have paid? So that's where please understand, in order to make us aware and collect the receipt, you'll have to, share your screenshot or payment details with us. And that's where we'll issue the receipt. And then you can say you're registered with TopYog. Now, Ambika is saying TopYog website is not working. Yes, Beta, because it's under construction. We wanted to redesign it. And because of the lockdown, there's a delay from the designer or the developer side. So we are also, expecting it to happen at short. So don't worry about that. Anyways, TopYog website, not having a TopYog website at this stage is not going to disturb us in any way or going to stop us from providing any services anyway. Okay. So don't worry about that. We are there. Website and right. May not be there, but we are there for you. Okay.
Right. And for students who've already paid, don't worry. We'll send you a receipt very soon. All right. So what is the way forward? What happens after you get registered?
Now,
what is the way forward with our classes?
Once you register, then now what is the way forward is we're discussing. Yes.
Right. So today's Sunday, we are giving you 2 days break. That is tomorrow and Tuesday. So Monday and Tuesday, there'll be no classes. So your live classes, the 5 live classes that we had, those ended today. So Monday and Tuesday, there'll be no classes. After that, what is the way forward? After that, every week you will be getting six, let's say on Wednesday, let's take an example of 1 day. As to in 1 day, what would you get? In 1 day, you would get a class of accounts, which will be of 2 hours. You will get a class of maths, which will again be of 2 hours. And with that, you will get a class of law or economics, which will again be of 2 hours. So 2 hours each accounts every day for 6 days in a week. Maths every day for 6 days in a week. Law and economics, we have divided them in 3 days per week. All right. So how many hours do you actually study? For accounts, you study 6 into 2. That is 12 hours in class. For maths, again, 12 hours in class. For law and economics each, you would study 6 hours each for each subject in the class, right? All right. So these classes are also recorded simultaneously. It is not the case that they're pre-recorded. It's not the case that we have already recorded the classes somewhere and giving it to you. No, we are simultaneously recording it with you. As in when you're studying, we are recording that simultaneously. And we'll be sending you those videos on incremental basis, right? On daily basis. It's not the case that we'll give all the videos together. We'll give you on an incremental basis. And what do we expect from you? We expect from you that you will study in phased manner or in disciplined manner, where you're completing the videos that we're giving you. You're completing the classes that we're giving you in a disciplined phase, in a disciplined manner or a phased manner.
So you can set your own timetable on a daily basis where you take out time to attend the classes for 6 hours. Like Wednesdays, that one said, you should have a schedule that, okay, Wednesday 6 hours, I need to sit to attend these classes. Which time, what time, that is up to you. Okay, that convenience you have got, you can decide. Okay, you may say, sir, I'll attend 2 hours accounts and then after 4 hours of break, I'll take maths. That's your wish. We'll be providing you these 3 sessions and then during the day, as and when you get the time or you have to take out time to study these classes. Okay, acha. One more thing which Tanisha is asking, what about the situation after lockdown? As we have discussed already, Tanisha, in our live classes which we have taken, that once the situation gets improved, it's not just about lockdown. Okay, lockdown might be relaxed, but then if situation is still the same, that means there is a risk. So then we will not be taking face-to-face classes. But if everything improves, then we'll be taking face-to-face classes. So obviously, instead of seeing the recorded classes, you'll have to come to the academy, come to the classes and physically attend them. Okay. But those who are not from Hyderabad, they will be given the recording of the face-to-face classes. So like we are giving now, same way we'll give them later as well. That's the only difference.
Right. So for students who are not in Hyderabad, they also need not worry. You will get on a continuous basis your online classes also.
Ambika and Dimple, yes, we would consider your suggestion for sure. We have noted your point. Thank you.
All right. So for doubts and tests, we've discussed already in our first class, in the respective classes also, and we went into detail as to how would we take tests and how would evaluation happen, how would the discussion happen, how are doubts clarified, right? So you need to download Telegram app. Again, I want to stress that point because there are a lot of people who have not downloaded Telegram app. And that is why we have to use WhatsApp right now. So our first thing was not to use WhatsApp. We were of the idea that we will use Telegram only because there's a security feature in Telegram where you cannot, let's say I don't want to share my number with the whole of the group. I am a student and I don't want my number to be shared with everyone. Then if you see in the Telegram group, you cannot see any other person's number who's actually in the group. You can see his name probably, but you cannot see actually as to what is his phone number, right? But in WhatsApp you can. So we want that security feature to be built in. So we request every one of you to just download Telegram app so that then we'll send updates only on Telegram and we'll close down this WhatsApp group.
And let me just repeat again, we would mandatorily, communicate only in Telegram group and not WhatsApp group once you register with TopYog. It's mandatory, it's not optional. Right now, maybe to give you that comfort, we have shared even in WhatsApp group, but very soon we'll delete that WhatsApp group and communicate only in Telegram group. And please understand, this is for your security again. We're not doing it just for our sake, we're doing it for your sake. If your number is being shared with, what can go wrong? So we don't want to take those chances. We just want to keep it safe, right?
Right. All right. Apart from that, there'll be a monthly interactive session, which will again be live. Like we're having an interactive session right now where we are discussing some things and we are entertaining your doubts or entertaining your queries also. In the same manner, we'll also have a monthly live interactive session where you can post your doubts or you can post your feedback as to how are your classes going or how are your things going. Anything that you want to share with us or anything that we want to share with you. We'll have an interactive session every month with the entire faculty. It'll not be just me and Gautam sir, but all the four faculty will be available on that particular session.
Okay. Now, let's go to their doubts. IIII, I think Soheb is there as IIII, who's asking, where is ICA branch of Hyderabad? It's at Lakdi Kapul, Red Hills. And right now it is closed. Then Rohan is asking that what is the last date of payment of fee? See, as in when you pay fee, you'll get registered with TopUp and from the next day onwards, you'll be able to view the classes. So if you don't want to get registered now, let's say, and you want to get registered after 10 days, then once you get registered, then you'll be provided with the videos. Because the first 5 classes of every subject has been uploaded on YouTube. But it's not that every class will be uploading on YouTube. So please understand, if you register, if you pay the fee, then you can get the videos. Then right. You can get the classes. Now, Nayan says, if situation is not good at last, no face-to-face classes. Yes, Nayan, of course not. Right now, government itself is saying that we cannot conduct any classes. No coaching institute, college, school can conduct. Same way, we are not conducting. So if situation doesn't improve, then maybe 4.5 or 5 months, what we are going to take might be only these recorded classes. There will be no face-to-face classes.
Right.
Yes.
All right. So there'll be another query as to how do we watch these classes, these recorded classes which we're giving you. How do you watch that? What is the procedure that you need to follow? So these classes from our end, we'll encrypt them and then we'll upload them. All right. So they're encrypted. If they're encrypted, that means they'll not open without a password. Right. So we'll give you a security key, which is a password. We'll give you an individualized security key, where that security key will be different or a unique number or a unique password for each one of you, right? So that security key, if you're using, then only you can access those classes. There's an app called RioPlayer. So through this RioPlayer, you need to download the classes, all right? So how does this RioPlayer work? I'll actually send you a video. I'll send you the video on WhatsApp as to how do you open the RioPlayer? How do you view the classes? How does an action class look on your mobile? You can watch all of it when I send you that video of actually of how am I accessing. I'll access it from my phone. I'll screen record my phone and I'll show you as to how do you go to RioPlayer, how do you download your classes, and how does it look also? How does it feel? How do you actually watch those? How would you feel while watching those recorded classes? All right. There's another query where people ask as to how many times can I view a class. So we have put a limit of 1.5 times, which I mean to say, let's say there's 200 hours of class in total of accounts. Let's say accounts in total for the entire batch that we're giving you is 200 hours. Then what will happen? What is 200 into 1.5? It is 300 hours, right? So these 100 additional hours, leave the 200 aside. 200, you'll obviously watch it. Like every class, you'll watch it once. So 200 would finish in that. The 100 extra hours are already there for you to go back and watch the class that you did not understand. Let's say there was a complex topic. Let's say a topic was not understood by you. You can actually go back to that particular topic, open that topic again, open that particular video again, and watch it again with the maximum limit of 300 hours in case the total number of hours is 200, right? So whatever is the total number of hours, you'll just need to multiply 1.5 to that in order to get as to how many times can you view a class.
Not Shreya, it's not like every class 100 extra hours, beta. Please understand, that was an
example.
So if let's say some subject has got 100 hours, let's say business laws is of 100 hours, then you will get 50 extra hours for that. You say, no sir, those 50 hours I don't want to use for business laws. Those 50 hours I want to use for accounts. Let's say you want to interchange them, it's possible. Because in totality, we will give you, let's say the total number of hours for all the papers put together, it's 600 hours. So you will get 900 hours viewing time. That means 600 hours anyways you will see, plus 300 hours which you want to use, you can use it for any subject, any topic that's left to you. The only idea which we are trying to give is 50% extra time will give for watching some topics again. Now Ambika is asking, sir, is it compulsory to download Rio Player app? Yes, because we are going to encrypt the video and send it to you. That right. Encrypted video will be played only in Rio Player app. One video, how many time watch? 1.5 times. One time anyway, anyways you will see. And again, you want to go back and see, then 50% off, as we said, is also available.
All right. To answer Dimple's query, Dimple is asking, on mobile, will we get recordings? Yes, you can access that particular, access our classes either through a mobile or through a laptop or through a computer. So it will be accessible through your mobile. Yes, you will have to download a software, Shruti. As we told you, Rio Player app will be the software that you need to download. Through Rio Player app, you can download the classes and view them.
See, and once you get registered, obviously we'll be helping you. Now, if you ask how does it work and all, I don't think that needs to be answered now. Okay, we will help you with how to download that Rio Player app. How does it work? Okay, who will give you technical support? All those type of things we'll take care. Don't worry. Once you get registered, then that's going to be on us, and we will be there to help you.
Right. So you'll get to
You can download on laptop. You can download on mobile. You can download on PC. You can download on in any of these devices. It's not a problem, Dimple.
Or a tab also.
Yeah, or a tab as well. It works on any of these.
Right. All right. So don't worry about how does that look or how do you access that app, because we'll send you a video separately as to how does actually Rio Player work and how do you download your classes and view them. All right. Okay. So before going on a virtual tour, do you have any more doubts?
Now, this is the second part which we have covered with respect to Top Yoga, like fee, how to watch classes, test, as we have covered in our classes, earlier live classes earlier. So all those things. Every day you send video. Yes, Baba, Sahil, that's what we said. Every day we'll be sending videos starting from Wednesday, not from Monday. Monday and Tuesday, we are taking a break. We are giving a break to you actually. And then from Wednesday onwards, we'll be sending 3 videos as Darpan sir has informed.
Naman, if you register now, you'll start getting classes from Wednesday.
Nayan, can you take up doubt of Nayan, Darpan sir?
Sir, if I watch classes and half class, I have some work. So I try after some time, I watch again. So I watched or not. You can pause that video, Naman. Wherever you want to pause, there's an option or there's a facility of pausing that video. So you can pause that video there at that point, and then you can do your work and come back to it and again play. Samket, I did not understand your question as to can I watch two view of video. What do you mean by two view?
Same video, I guess he wants to watch two times. Where's the time actually?
You can watch two times the same video also. It's not like 1.5 times is restricted to one video. When we're giving an example or when we're saying 1.5 times, that is for an entire course. So you need not apply that 1.5 times to restrict it to one video. You will have to see on the totality of it. So you have to see the total number of hours that is there in one subject. To that, you will have to apply 1.5 times. So you can watch one video twice
also.
You have
to use this 50% extra which we are providing carefully for the selected topics where you find difficulty. See, Akanksha, again, you're asking the same doubt, Beta, which we have cleared. Already we have said that if you have doubt relating to any particular subject, every subject wise, there will be a Telegram group made by the respective faculty. You can post your doubt there. And if required, we can have a call as well for clearance of the doubt.
Yes, Nayan, you can watch the video at any time. No, not only that day. You can watch it at any time. But we want you to make sure that you watch it that day, or maximum, let's say you did not watch it today, watch it the next day, Because if you keep a lot of videos pending, then that pending videos will just add up to a lot of videos.
Just imagine Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, you did not watch videos. So then Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, if you have not watched, that means 3 days you have not watched the videos. So Saturday, you will have to watch 4 days video, which will be really difficult. So it's not advisable. You need to watch it on a daily basis. You need to bring in that discipline, like how face-to-face classes you have discipline. Same way you need to bring discipline in watching even online.
Also, we are telling you for every one of you to watch it on incremental basis or on daily basis so that let's say the lockdown gets opened up and we are starting face-to-face classes. Then what would happen? Then obviously we will not teach you the things that we've taught online. So we'll not teach you or we'll not conduct the classes for the subjects or for the chapters that we've already covered in our online classes. We'll start from the point where we've left in online classes. So you all have to be on the same page for that, right? So you will have to watch it daily.
So let's say we have covered 6 topics in online mode. We have sent the videos for 6 topics. Now the situation improves and now we'll have face-to-face classes, let's say. So face-to-face classes, when we begin, we will continue from where we left. That means from 7th topic. Don't think that we'll start again from 1st topic in our face-to-face classes. That won't happen. So you have to attend, you have to watch those videos on a daily basis. And whenever the situation improves and we are going to conduct face-to-face classes, we'll be at par with what is going to be taken up in face-to-face class.
All right.
Someone is asking, what about the deleting of the videos? See, you can download them and keep and then play with the password, which will give you the key, serial key. That is the password which will provide. You can use that password and play. So we are not asking you to delete. We are giving those videos to you. You will download through that app and view it. And if you want to keep it, you keep it. But that can open only with the password.
Right.
These questions, see, guys, please understand. If you are interested to join Topyuk Educations, if you want to get registered, these type of questions, anyways, we will discuss in detail. Our agenda is not to get into this now. We just wanted to show you this is the mechanism we'll follow. So the specific queries relating to this can be taken up once you get registered. We'll be helping you out. Someone is asking, can I call you? Yeah, we have already given our numbers, right? You can call and in case you want to get some information, we are there.
Yeah. In case you're asking for doubts, if you can call us for subject related doubts, then that we've already told you that you have to post your doubts on Telegram group. The faculty or the lecturer would take a call as to whether that needs to be clarified on Telegram or on phone. All right.
There will be only one password, Priyal, for one student.
Yes.
Only one password for one student for all the papers. So Priyal Agrawal will get only one password. That's it.
So that's why we are saying individualized security key.
Yeah.
It's an individual security key. That security key will be only one for one person. It will not change.
Mayank is asking some question, Darpan. Let's take this question as last question for our second part. Once video is deleted, can we download it again? He's asking this question.
So is Mayank, are you saying that we delete the video or you have deleted the video? Mayank, did you delete the video from your phone or did Topyuk delete the video? If you have deleted the video from your phone, then you can again download it. You can again download it.
And if you have any queries of this sort, let's say our technical team is also there. If sometimes, let's say the Rio player gets stuck, or maybe you say that you're not able to view it properly. There is a technical team of ours, which will be helping you from Monday to Saturday. They're there to help you out. Don't worry about that. Subject wise, we are there and technical issues will be handled by a separate team.
So Sahil is asking, if he gets registered, when can he get the books of ICI? So right
that,
now, since
no one can say,
yeah, right now there's
the situation, how the situation is and the services now. So we cannot say anything on that part.
Correct. All right. So do we move on?
Yeah, please.
Okay. So the next, what is the next agenda? The next agenda is to take you on a virtual tour of how does an actual ICI website look like and what is BOS Knowledge Portal. So let's go to that website now.
If you have any other query, you can keep it after this particular part. Huh? As I've told you, once we complete this part of website of ICI, if you still have some questions, you can ask later. Let us first complete this third part. First, we have completed registration at ICI, second about TopYug, and now we are going to the virtual tour of ICI website. So kindly concentrate here.
Sir, can you see the website?
Yes.
All right. So this is what this have typed, www.icai.org. So what is the website that you need to type in your, what is the link that you need to type? You need to type www.icai.org in order to open this website. All right. So when you open this website, there are various tabs that you can see above, right?
1 minute, like, Darpan, go back and show them how did you come here.
Okay, let me type www.icai.org. So if I do this, this is the website that gets opened. And then here there's, please click here for browsing the website www.icai.org.
I hope you're able to see the right-hand side bottom corner where now the hand is placed, the cursor is placed, please click here. So that's where you need to click.
Right. So you can take up the questions which are coming in chat box because I cannot see the chat box.
No, we will
now.
Not take up any session now.
All right.
First,
we are not taking questions.
Complete.
All right.
First, let us complete this part and then we'll take up questions.
Sure.
So I request even the participants not to raise any question now. Let us just go this uninterrupted way. And once we complete this virtual tour, then obviously we are there to take up any question. Okay, guys, I hope you understand.
All right. So if you see the website, there are various tabs, right? There's overview tab, there's departments tab, members, students, industry resources, showcase, other important links and FAQs. So if
you
go to
the cursor, Darpan sir, to show them.
If you go to the students tab, you get more options then, right? Or if you click on the students tab also, let's say you clicked it, all those options which are coming there, which will be again coming here, where you can click on the option that you want to go in, right? So somebody was asking as to, sir, I was not able to access my registration form, or where do I access that registration form from? So if you click on students, I clicked on students, right? Then these are the tabs that got opened. Now, in these, there's course registration forms, right? If you see the fourth one, where my cursor is. If I click on this, then it will open one more tab, which will ask me if you're applying for foundation or through CPT or through direct entry. What are we? We are students of foundation. So you would click here. If you click there, there'll be another website which will open up. This is your website where you actually register yourself. So where will you click here? It says new students who wants to register for CA for first time, right? You don't have your user ID and password right now. You did not register yourself. What would you do? You would click here where you want to register for CA for the first time. So if you click here, there'll be a tab open, which I showed you earlier, right? Now, these everything we've discussed as to what happens after you fill this. You get an OTP, then you get registered, you get a username and password. Then you go back to this and put your user ID and password, and then those forms you will get those forms, right? So this is the process of registration as to what do you do in order to get yourself registered with ICI. Where did I find that? I found that in students tab in course registration forms, right? All right. Let's say you want to study more about as to what is chartered accountancy course, I want to know as to what is involved in this, what are the subjects involved, what are the stages involved, or what is the fees involved. Everything about that you would find in chartered accountancy course. So if I click on that, I would get a prospectus, I would get a scheme of education and training, what are the trainings involved, what is the curriculum of CA course, what are the subjects involved, what are the levels involved in CA. You can read in the prospectus or in Board of Study one-stop referencer, which will give you a chart as to what is the procedure in order to become a chartered accountant right from starting from CA Foundation. All right. So that is about,
so there is a lot of information, I mean, at your fingertip. If you have questions, ICI is helping you with the answers for the questions. It's just that we need to go and visit the website and read, have the patience to go through them. If we have that, then we have answers for almost all the questions.
Right. So then coming to Board of Studies announcements. So all announcements that ICI make, they put out that announcement on their website. Now, what can be these announcements? The announcement that I told you earlier about provisional registration, that you can get registered provisionally if you don't have your 12th mark sheet. That also is an announcement. Again, postponement of exams. If you're following, then these exams which were going to be held in May, they're postponed now. That is also an announcement which they will again put it on the out on this website, right? So these announcements also you can find here. So your respective announcement as to what do you want to read on. If you want to find an announcement on foundation course, you can click on foundation course. Or if you want to know the important announcements across all the areas, then you can click on important announcements. Right? And there'll be date also. So if you, there'll be a heading as to what is that announcement about. And in the end, you'll find the date of the announcement. So this was announced on 2nd May. Likewise, this was announced on 19th April.
Provisional announcement is there. Darpan sir, you can show them. It was there.
It was under important announcements or foundation.
Yes.
Right. So if you see the cursor where it is placed, allowing provisional registration and foundation course of ICI for students who have allotted either admit card or appeared in one or more papers of class 12 examinations. Right. It's not asking you for your results, but your admit card or here. If I open the announcement would be here. You can see the date and you can see the announcement as to what is it about.
So see, like we were discussing in our business laws classes, that if government wants to communicate with us, okay, they want to share any new law, amendment, notification, anything, they use official gazette. Same way, please understand ICA, if they want to communicate with members or students, they don't use official gazette, but they post it on their website or app. There's an app also of ICI. So right. We can visit that website or app and we can get to know. You might say, sir, don't they WhatsApp, don't they text, or don't they put it on Facebook and all? No, it's formal mode of communication which they're using. Moving ahead or maybe going forward, if they do that, I don't know. But right now it is the website or the app through which they communicate.
All right. So these were Board of Studies announcements. And then we'll go to what is BOS Knowledge Portal. Now, what is Board of Studies Knowledge Portal? This is where you can find your knowledge material. What do I mean by knowledge material? Your books, your previous exam questions, your study material. So if I go into foundation course, what are you studying right now? You're studying foundation course. So click on that. You will have syllabus as your first tab. And then your papers, right? Let's say if I click on paper one, which is accounting, you'll get study material, questions for practice, revision test papers, mock test papers, question papers, suggested answers. These all information is available to you for free. You need not pay anything to get this information.
You can open one and show them, like study material.
Right.
See, the study material which they're going to courier you, the physical ones, okay, are there in PDF format here as well.
So this is your chapter one, unit one of accounts. So if you see, this will be the exact, this is the exact copy of what would you receive in your hard copy material. This is the entire chapter one, unit one, where you would have your theory, and then you would also have your questions in the end. These are test your knowledge, so multiple choice questions. Then there'll be theoretical questions. And then also there'll be answers to those multiple choice questions and theoretical questions. All right. So you can use this database to actually gain more knowledge. This is the module. So these are the textbooks. Likewise, there'll be question papers. There'll be revision test papers. There'll be mock test papers. There'll be suggested answers to those papers.
See, what do we mean by suggested answers? Please understand that as well. Suggested answer means answers to the previous examination questions. the questions which were asked in the past examination, okay, will be answered, right? So those answers are available in the form of suggested answers. Sir, you can just show them one.
Yeah. Suggested answers. So these are the question papers. So if I want to see the November 2019 question paper.
No, you can show them the suggested.
Yeah, I'll open.
Yeah, okay. Answers. Sorry. This is the question paper, correct?
Those were the question papers. Suggested answers is on another tab. And if I open one suggested answer, you can also see the paper pattern here. Let's say you're confused about what is the paper pattern, how are the questions actually asked. You can come here and see as to what were the questions asked and how are they drafted or what is the format that they use in order to ask the questions. So we'll not go into detail of it because anyways, Gautam sir has covered all this in his first class. So these are the answers also that they're giving. So this is the answer to your first question, right?
And see, every faculty, every teacher in their respective subject will be talking about this. It's just that we have started with our classes now. So obviously when we cover topics and all, we'll be taking you through the different questions asked in the examination, okay, and helping you out. It's just that today we want you to, know all these things so that later on you'll know, okay, these resources are there. And if I want, I can take the help of it. So that was our basic idea. At least you should have an idea about these things.
Right. Because what happens is these all resources are available with you and you can access them without paying any charge. But most of the students, actually, they don't get to know about this, at least at foundation level. Like when I was a CPT student, I did not know that this amount of information is actually available on the net for me to, access. So when you don't know that, obviously you will not go and access that, right? Or if you get to know at a very later stage, let's say the exams are due in like 15-20 days and then you are getting to know that there's information available, then you cannot utilize that properly, right? That is why the motive of ours was to tell you beforehand as to these are all the information that you can actually use and it is available for free. So you need not pay anything and you can use them anywhere and at any time. So this website is completely accessible from mobiles also. It's very easy to access. Like I opened a PDF, that PDF will automatically open in your mobile also when you go to their website.
Yeah, can you go back to students tab again, sir?
Yes. Yeah.
Students tab.
This is
so now you could see that we have taken you to the course registration form in the students registration. Then we have seen Board of Studies knowledge portal. We have seen also Board of Studies announcements. Same way, we have some examination related stuff there. And if you see the last one, if you just observe the last one, examination and fee concession.
Scholarship
and fee concession. So you have something called as scholarship and fee concession from ICI also. So if you fall into that category, that means if you're eligible, you can just have a look at it. We will not take you through that. But I'm just showing you that in case you want some concession or scholarship from ICI, okay, you fit into their eligibility criteria, then you can apply it to them. So you can just view whenever you have some time. Okay. And the other things also, which are there, as Darpan sir has told you earlier, like chartered accountancy course, or if you want to know about practical training and all, you have a lot of information on ICI website, which can help you, which can guide you. Okay. From time to time, we are anyways there, but ICI also is doing their part. So when they're collecting that 9,200, 9,800, it's not that they're not providing you anything. It's not that they're just collecting fee. They're providing you a lot of information. Okay. So this was with respect to the ICI website. Now, let's switch on the video and the audio as well, I guess. Let's see each other. And if you have any questions, you can raise your hand and then we'll give you a chance. So one by one, you can speak and we can answer as well. Okay.
We'll unmute you when you text us that you want to get unmuted.
No, I guess because we can unmute everyone.
Everyone, then again that background.
Okay, let's unmute Priyal. Priyal, you can unmute yourself and maybe you can switch on your video as well.
One second. I'll have to do that.
Priyal has some question, so we can take up Priyal's question.
Yes, Priyal, you're unmuted.
One minute,
Priyal. As I said, please switch on your video as well.
Okay, sir.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, Priya, go ahead. Can you hear
me,
sir?
If you want to take other person's book, yeah, yeah, go ahead.
If I want to take the latter person's book who are studying CA Foundation, will it help me or I need to register and take the fresh books?
See, as I've told you, registration is mandatory. It's not optional. If you want to do CA course, you have to get registered with ICAI. If you say, no, my senior already has some books of foundation, so I'll not get registered, that's not going to help. It's not allowed only.
Okay, sir.
Right. So the fee which you are paying, 9,200 plus let's say 600 for journal, 9,800, they will give you books in that only. There is no separate charge for books. Separate charge is only for examination. When you will be writing examination in November 2020, that time you have to separately fill up one form for examination, and there's a separate examination fee also for that. Apart from that, for foundation course, there will be no other fee. So two fee you have to pay, one registration fee and second is examination fee later. And right. That is nominal amount. I don't remember exact amount.
That's about 1,000 or 200.
Yeah, 1,200. Yeah, something like that is the examination fee, which later on you might have to pay.
Correct.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay, all Priya. Right. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, Priya.
Who's the next? Arpit. Arpit, you can switch on your video.
Arpit, I'll unmute him.
Okay. Yes, Arpit.
Yes, Arpit, we can hear you.
Arpit, you have to unmute yourself. You're muted.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Arpit, go ahead. Yes, Arpit, ask your doubt.
Arpit
is very casual.
Sir, there is another fees along with fees like GST.
No. ICI is not collecting any other fee. Whatever is the fees, this which is in front of you.
No, sir.
Same way we have said that TopUK is collecting 15,000, then that's it. We didn't say 15,000 plus GST or 18,000 plus GST. There's no other fee.
Yes, sir.
Right.
Okay, Arpit. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, Arpit.
Next, Shruti. Shruti has some questions. Sir, once situation is under control, will you send us books through courier? Yes, we would. If you are not a Hyderabad-based student, then we would send. If you are a Hyderabad-based student, you will have to come and collect. Because anyways, then maybe we'll have face-to-face classes as well. Yeah, any other question?
So Shruti is asking, TopUK's books, sir.
Yeah, that's what I said.
If the situation is under control, then will you...
Yeah. Yes, that's what. ICAI will anyway send. There's no thought about it. And same way, TopUK also will provide, but Hyderabad-based students, we don't courier. Okay.
Correct.
But outstation students, yes, we'll courier.
Right.
Yeah, any other question from any other participant, please, you can ask now. It might be relating to anything. Now, here is the time where you can ask any question.
It's all right if you don't want to unmute yourself also. You can just type your question and ask us.
Yeah, if you're not comfortable by chance.
Yeah, if you're not comfortable, if there's a disturbance near you, you can just type your question also.
I hope the session is informative and we are able to answer many of your questions. If informative, please type informative so that we understand.
Or how is the session in general? Like, how did you find the session?
Mayank, as I've told you, examination fee is not included in registration fee. Examination fee is separately required to be paid to ICAI. Okay, that will be done maybe in the month of September or August.
Right.
September. Yes, correct. November. So September, you will be required to pay. And that is some nominal amount, like we said, around 1,200. Sumit says the physical book. What physical book, beta? You're giving clue. You're not giving us the query. You're not raising your query.
No. There's a query above that. He's asking, will the books which you will provide, will that cost extra?
Which we will provide? No.
Right.
No.
All right.
There are no hidden charges anywhere. Please understand. And someone is asking, sir, if I get already registered, I have not got the books. Yes, because of the lockdown situation, how do you expect ICI to send the books to you? It's not possible. Once the situation improves, then definitely ICI will be sending you the books. Priyal says, sir, if I register today, when will I get my books? No one can tell you that. Priyal, please understand, I'm repeatedly saying this. No one can guarantee, no one can answer this question as to when will you get your books physically in your hand. Same way, when will you have face-to-face classes?
The ICI president will also be not able to answer that question.
Yeah, yes, correct. No one will be able to answer. We are sorry, but this is how it is now because of the lockdown situation.
Correct. But that doesn't hamper your studies because anyways, those books that we have showed you, they're all available online. So you don't stop your studies or you don't delay your studies in the fact that, no, I'll get my books, then only I will read from the physical books.
Yeah, I understand one difficulty there because we are used to the pattern of holding the book, having that feel of the book in our hand, underlining. Yes, that is there. Even I'm used to that. Correct. But now we have to change. And there's no other option for anyone, beta.
Right.
Sorry, Priyal, you don't have to be sorry for anything. It's completely okay. Yes, guys, any other doubt, please share. Otherwise, we can end the session. We are good to end the session. Achha, one thing, Darpan sir, I think we forgot to share about the ICI head office, regional office. Let's just share with them on the website. Guys, hold on. There's one thing which we forgot. Let's just share with that. Share that with you.
So when you come to the website, let's say I'm on the home department. Let's go back. Let's come back to home. You will find contact us here. Like on the right side of the portion, on the upper right side, you'll find contact us option here. So when you click on that option of contact us, there you will get a lot of information about the different branches and the chapters and the councils that they have. So if I take the example of us, where do we fall in? So if you see here.
No, first 1 minute.
Yeah.
First is ICI head office, if you see.
Correct.
ICI head office is at New Delhi. Okay. I'm talking about ICI now. ICI head office is New Delhi, as you could see. Okay, Indraprastha Mark. That is the head office of ICI. Now coming to regional offices. The whole of the country, they have grouped into some regions. If you just see five regions.
They are
saying there is central region, northern region, western region, eastern region, as well as
south,
southern region. Okay. So that way they have divided, they have grouped the, not, I'll not say divided, but grouped the states into regions. And we guys fall under southern region if we are from Hyderabad. Okay, so sir can take you through that SIRC and
so
branches.
So if I put on SIRC, so those S there means southern, W means west, western, N means north. So if I press on SIRC and if I press on branch, let's say SIRC and branches directory. That is when I can get the whole of the information of the centers that are there in South.
Like someone was asking, where is Hyderabad's branch office, right? Someone asked, no. So you can find it here, Hyderabad branch. Okay, as I was telling you, Lakdi Kapul, Red Hills. So they have given the address as well. And if you say, sir, I want to know the phone number, I want to visit the website of Hyderabad branch, that is also available here. So if you just go back, you'll find branch websites.
If you want to go to their website, then click on branch websites.
So Hyderabad is there, listed there. So see, this is the Hyderabad's website. You can find total details there. These are the office bearers of Hyderabad branch office as of now. So a lot of information there. If you have some other questions or if you have some grievances, you can raise here. Okay. Yeah. So this is one more thing which we actually thought we'll be covering. So Hyderabad, one thing. Hyderabad office is a branch office. Now you might say, sir, where is regional office? We fall under southern region. And the regional office of south region is in Chennai. Okay.
Right.
So head office is in Hyderabad, regional office is in Chennai, and the branch office is in Hyderabad for us. Now someone who's in Warangal might say, sir, is a branch in Warangal also there? You can check out. SIRC and branches, you can go there and you can just check whether Warangal is a branch. If I'm right, Warangal has got a branch. You can just check.
There is.
Darpan sir can help you. Yeah, see, Warangal branch is there. Same way, if you say I'm in Vishakhapatnam, is there a branch? Yes. Regional office is in Chennai. Head office is in Hyderabad. Okay, just for your information, in case you are required to contact them, no? So at least you should have an idea. So that's why we thought of sharing this. Okay, guys. So now quickly tell me, all of you have followed today's session and you have no doubts and we can end the session or not. So please quickly type, quickly ping so that we can end the session then. Okay, thank you so much. Yeah, Priyal, I appreciate too. Thank you. Yeah, Arshil, thank you so much. Yeah, Suhaib.
Thank you.
Great. Yes, Shreya, Shruti, Dimple. Thank you, beta. Sumit, thanks. Yeah, God bless you. All of you, God bless you. Shruti, yeah. So I think good to end the session. Thank you so much. Yeah, all God right. bless you all.
Thank you,
Darpan sir.
Have a good day. Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye.